Here's a bear. We probably agree that the bear is alive, but how about the soil it's sitting on? That definitely isn't a living thing, right? It doesn't do a lot of the key things living things do, like moving and reproducing. But ask scientists whether soil is alive, and the answer, more often than not, is yes. What's going on? Welcome to Minute Earth. Soil actually has a lot more in common with a bear and all other living things than you might think. Just like all the stuff that makes up the bear, living stuff, dead stuff, minerals, air, and water, are constantly working together and sustaining each other so the bear can keep doing its beary things, soil is also made up of a system of living stuff, dead stuff, minerals, air, and water. That's right, these things don't just exist in soil, they are the soil, and they're constantly working together as a dynamic, self-regulating system. You might call it a living system. Then there's the fact that living things interact with their surroundings in all sorts of ways. A bear, for instance, gobbles up resources from its habitat and spreads nutrients around. And soil, too, is a dynamic link in its ecosystem. Its air-filled pores help regulate a fluctuating water flow. Soil helps transform an ecosystem's dead stuff into easily accessible nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, and carbon that other life needs. And it serves as a storehouse for extra nutrients until they're required. And maybe the most compelling argument for soil being alive is that it can die. Like a bear, soil can lose its ability to carry out all its internal processes and external interactions. Like, if soil's air-filled pores get too smashed, it starts losing its ability to hold water, leading to floods and erosion. If certain nutrients get depleted, soil loses its ability to support life. And soil that can't support life can't support us. It can't grow the food we need to stay alive, or store the carbon needed to stave off climate change. So whether or not you actually believe soil is alive, it's useful to think about it as being alive, since that can help us understand how soil functions as a complex, dynamic system, and how it can change over time, especially as a result of our actions. What's more, it gives us a vocabulary to talk about those changes. In fact, it can be helpful to think and talk about all sorts of maybe not technically living things, from the ocean to the economy, as having living properties. In the end, that may help us ensure these things can stay alive, and that we can stay alive too. If you want to know more about soil health or other aspects of global restoration, you should check out Restore, a new site founded by the folks at Crowther Lab at ETH Zurich, the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology, who sponsored this video. Restore is an open data platform that enables everyone everywhere to get involved in restoration. You can find a project to support or volunteer with, share info about your own project, or simply see what kind of restoration is going on in your area or anywhere else you're interested in. Crowther Lab believes that with access to the right tools, we can all contribute to the sustainable use of the land we depend on. To learn more about your land footprint and to get involved with the diverse community of people restoring Earth's ecosystems, check out restore.eco.